go somewhere a little different and see what's open. Ah, Carolina Thread Trail. Maybe that is where, we go into, like they have in North Carolina. Regional network of greenways and trails linking 15 counties in North Carolina and South Carolina. Oh. So it linked in both. Okay then. I did not know that. This was a link in both states. I love this area. So nice. Nice to see something different. You can kind of smell the river though. So here's where it splits off in our first part of the adventure. Our first part of the adventure begins. Across there is a bridge. That way goes to the nature trail. That way goes to the canal trail. So what do? Where do we go from here? Do we go to the canal trail? Or to the nature trail? Or to the museum trail? Oh, there's the museum too. Where is the museum? And over here, it says the dam. As a boat approached the canal, traveling south on the Catawba River, the patroon on the riverboat pilot first saw the diversion dam. The dam consisted of piles of loose stone on the river bottom. The dam projected from the bank at roughly 40 degrees and did not completely cross the river. It was designed simply to keep a sufficient water supply flowing through the canal when the river was low to maintain an area of calm water to prevent boats from being swept into shoals during the flood. So, we are going to go on the canal trail, and that's going to do it for part one. Someday, we might go on that trail. Today, the canal trail is our stop. So join us in part two as we go on this adventure in Landsford, Cannal, South Carolina. This is part one. See you in part two. I don't know how you guys felt about that intro or not, but I wanted to show some parts of the woods. There's a lot of people out there. Already starts. This is the guard lock. This is our first stop. Now, if you know dams, every dam has a guard where they have to stop the water from flowing in. And these are called locks, and it was used for boats and canals in high river threats to destroy the town. And when it was normal, when the water level was normal, it was like kept at a lower level. But this was this kept the water from rising too high and destroying the towns. So without this, there would be no there would be nothing to protect them from the towns. Unlike what happened with the New Orleans when the levees broke, that was because they weren't enough, they didn't have enough strength to stop the ocean from coming in. And unfortunately, that was when the water was that year, the Hurricane El Nino. I forget. But that really had an effect on what caused the levees to break. And unfortunately, the town was too low for it to handle that much water coming in from the ocean. They thought they were ready, but they weren't. No matter how many sandbags you had, you couldn't stop the water from breaking the dam. So, in many cases, our first stop, the lock bridge. So, see you in the next.